Suppose you time yourself as you walk in the same direction and on a moving walkway. It takes you 15.8 seconds to travel the entire length of the 100-foot walkway. Now you decide to walk the wrong way on the moving walkway, and it takes you 75 seconds to go the same distance. Assuming your walking rate and the walkway rate remain constant, how fast were you walking, and how fast is the walkway moving? So this is very similar to going in a boat downstream and upstream, or being in an airplane and flying with the jet stream and against the jet stream, that's with the wind and without the wind, or against the wind. This problem is the same idea, but just with a different example. So we have a moving walkway, and it's moving, say, from left to right. And you are on this moving walkway, also walking in the same direction. And that's that first scenario, where it takes you only 15.8 seconds to go the 100 feet. There's the second scenario, where the moving walkway is moving at the same rate from left to right, but you are walking in the opposite direction. You're moving from right to left. And presumably you are walking faster than that, than the rate of the walkway, because you do gain some ground and eventually get to the end. It takes you quite a bit longer, though. So what is happening here? Well, first of all, let's define some variables. It's a very good start. After you draw a picture, it's a good start to define some variables. So I'm going to go to U as W. I'm going to name W as your walking rate. And we'll use W then when we plug that into the formulas or the equations. I'll make M equal to the moving walkway rate. Now, let's think about what's happening here. We know that rate times time equals distance, the classic formula for motion problems. The rate in this first scenario, the rate is going to be your walking rate plus the moving walkway rate. This moving walkway, by the way, that's one of those horizontal escalators, is what it looks like. It's got the metal floor, or sometimes it's looks like a conveyor belt. It's a long conveyor belt that's at a grocery store or something. But you can stand on it, or you can walk along and go a little faster. Okay, you see that a lot of times at the airports. So your rate plus the rate of the moving walkway is what is the ground you'll be gaining. So I'm going to add those. I'm going to say your walking rate plus the moving walkway rate multiplied by the time. And the time is given to us as 15.8 seconds equals your distance, also given as 100 feet. Next, we have the scenario where your rate is being impeded by this flow of the river or the flow of the wind or whatever it is. In this case, it's the walkway. You're walking upstream, if you will. So your rate, you will have to subtract from your rate the rate of the moving walkway. So your rate minus the moving walkway's rate times this time, rate times time, this time is the 75 seconds, equals the same distance, 100 feet. Okay, we're dealing in feet and seconds, so our rates at the end will be in feet per second. So remember that, and I'll add that at the end. Okay, we could solve this system of equations a number of ways. I can see that if we got rid of these multipliers, we could just add these down and the m's would cancel out. So, or would it be eliminated? So let's do that. On each of these equations, I'm going to divide by these multipliers. So divide by the times 15.8 in the first one, and dividing by 75 in the second equation. That will give us, as a result, I'm going to move right over here, W plus M equals 6.2911, and I rounded there. You can take that out to a few more decimal places if you'd like. And the second equation is W minus M equals 1 1/3, or 1.3 repeated. I'll just take it to four decimal places. Now, if we are to add those, then we're going to be left with a W. So I'm actually going to do this in red, because that's our W is our walking rate. So we get 2W, and M and negative M cancel out. So 2W equals 7.6244. And then divide by 2, and we get a walking rate of 3.8 feet per second. That's our walking rate, and that's actually pretty accurate for an average walking rate, 3.8 feet per second. Just as with any system of equations, once you know the solution of one of the variables, take it and plug it into one of the original equations, and then solve for the remaining variable. So I'll plug in 3.8 in for W. I get 3.8, I'll use the first equation, plus M equals 6.2911. All we have to do here is subtract 3.8 from each side, and the rate of the moving walkway then is 2.5 feet per second. So if you are writing this down, you have the walking rate of 3.8 feet per second, and the moving walkway rate, that's the rate of the machine, as 2.5 feet per second.